Solomon was born, God said, I loved him. His name should be Jedida. That was his name. Before he turned to Solomon, Jedida is what God gave me. Beloved of the Lord. That is your name from today. In the spirit, that's your name from today. Go to anybody you want to go to. Only three people. If the person, you're not sure that this person is going to be a blessing, don't talk to that person. Go to another person. You are permitted today. Tell that person, I want to announce my beauty. I'll be made beautiful by Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Beauty. 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 Make sure you say to somebody you trust. Now begin to clap for Jesus for yourself, because it is so. You may be seated. And I think I'll be very fast with this message. We have wonderful things to do today. We thank God for the programs we are running in this church. Shall we clap for Jesus? 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 I am particularly happy because what I know the Lord has done that we are going to receive today, we are already receiving them. This is not what I prepared, but the Lord changed it now. So the title of my message is called Make Me Beautiful. Make Me Beautiful. Make Me Beautiful. It's still within our series on favor. Only favor can make you beautiful. It was favor that found David with the animals and took him to the palace. Somebody is going from low to high today. So I want to give you one or two or three things that God will do for you now that will make your life beautiful. First of all, if you are here and you have been emptied, you have been drained, all your wealth stolen, all your glory emptied, there is nothing in your warehouse, everything has been siphoned by the powers of darkness, and you are left with sickness, failure, setback, frustration, delays, poverty, hardship, struggling, disfavor, management of shame and disgrace, I have a news for you. It will no longer be a story. My message changed. So I am declaring. So please don't let it fall to the ground. I said, if you have been experiencing this thing I describe now, the favor that will land now, as I speak, will put your story to a new level of glory. You will never again be empty. And I have the word of God to support it. And we're going to read it. And when they finish reading it, we are all going to read it together. First, they read it for us. Then you understand. And I want to read it in New Living Translation. Something that will happen for you now. If you have New Living Translation, you understand it better. I hope. Isaiah 54. Isaiah 5:4. From verse 1 to 3.
Isaiah 54.
Yep.
Verse 1 to 3.
Mm-hmm.
Sing, O childless woman, you who have never given birth, break into loud and joyful song. O Jerusalem, you have never been in labor, for the desolate woman now has more children than the woman who lives with her husband, says the Lord. Verse 2, enlarge your house, build an addition, spread out your home, and spare no expense, for you will soon be bursting at the seam. Your descendants will occupy other nations and resettle their ruined cities.
And so some people don't understand what I read there. I will interpret it so that you understand. I just kept quiet so that she would read it. Then I will explain it to you. It's not talking of only barren women. Anyone whose life is not productive is barren. Anyone who is not walking in the glory that you had from the beginning, you are barren. Anyone who has not reached where he's supposed to go is barren. Any fruitless tree is barren. Anyone that is not producing at the speed it should produce because of demonic interference, you are barren. He said, rejoice. For though you were made barren, you shall have more than those who thought they were blessed. Though you were emptied, you should better start building expansion to your house. Because the rain that is about to fall, 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 that is about to fall. You will need more room. Remember, let me make your faith stronger. Remember when Elisha told that woman, he said, Do you have anything in the house? He said, only this thing and this thing. He said, eh. He said, okay. Go and borrow. He said, where? Bring containers. He said, containers. He said, we don't have many. Only this one. He said, no. Go and borrow more containers. So, because when God wants to bless you, he will give you beyond what you can hold. The mistake the enemy made is that they emptied you. They should not have done it. Because you would have remained with the little God gave you. Now, because they emptied you, you are now going to go and expand your house. You are going to go and expand your house, your home, your barn, your account, your business, your life, your career. Because what is coming now is big, 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 big. You can't hold it. Anytime you see God talk of surplus, I mean blessing, it doesn't talk within our limit. Even when he said, try me and see if I will not open what? The windows of heaven. And pour down blessings. That what will happen? That you cannot have place, room to contain. This scripture says, I should tell you, expand your house. Remember, this is not what I prepared. It was changed, and I love it.
When you prepare something and the Lord, no, when he changes it, oh, because he wants to do something extraordinary. I congratulate you for being in this service. For the first time in the life I came to this Namibia, for the first time, the anointing of increase in my life is about to release. It's moving. Everything that you didn't have before, consider it done. And I'm not saying you will have what you wanted. It will be over, shaking together, pressed down, overflowing, that you are going to have, because you need to expand your house. Asha sharaba sharaba. Asha sharaba sharaba. Read that scripture again.
Isaiah 54 verse 1 to 3. Sing, O childless woman, you who have never given birth. Break into loud and joyful song, O Jerusalem. You who have never been in labor.
You have never married. You have never had a job. You have never had a account. You have never had a car. You have never had a house. You have never had children. You have never had favor. You have never had... You have never had anything. You say, rejoice! For you are about to overtake those who had it before you. Shout, overtake!
For the desolate woman now has more children than the woman who lives with her husband, says the Lord.
Did you hear that? He said, the woman that was emptied, you that was emptied of husband, of favor, of wife, of farm, of business, of money, of career, of certificate, of job, of good health. He said, today, not tomorrow, today, now, you are getting, you have received, and it is here beyond, above everyone that ever had in your life. Sharabasha! Sharabasha! I'm serving a God of miracles. I know, yes, I know I'm serving. Oh, I'm serving
God of miracle. I know, yes, I know I'm serving.
I'm serving a God of
miracles. I know, yes, I know
we are serving.
I'm serving a God of miracle. I know, yes, I know.
People go ask me, say, waiting, they make me shine.
I have to tell them, say, my Jesus, they make me shine.
People, they ask me, say,
people, they ask me, say,
waiting, they make me shine.
Waiting, they make me shine.
I have to
tell them, say, my Jesus, they make me shine.
I shine, I
shine, I shine.
As from now, that's what will be happening to you. People will be asking you, what is the secret? What is going on? Now you are having weekend rest. in Hilton. Now you're having weekend rest. In South Africa. Now you are taking off for just a week to spend some holiday in Mauritius. You told the woman that they were asking you about account. You said, no, I'm paying cash. Yeah. And then, how did you break gold card? Wow. Everything I just said now is for you.
It's for you. It's for you.
I just described you, and as I've said it, for it is written, he confirms the words of his servants and fulfills the counsel of his ministers.
Receive.
When you take this communion and the anointing that will happen today, every emptiness in your life will be, wait, let me say this now. It will be expanded to accommodate the blessing. Yeah. Empty womb will give birth to twins. Yeah. Empty bank account will give birth to overflow for nurses. Yeah. Empty brain will give birth to A+, A+, A+. Empty marriage will become a glorious marriage. Useless children will become useful people. So shall it be. And so it is now and forever in your life in the name of Jesus. You may be seated. I need to hurry. You haven't seen nothing. You're about to see something. Amen. Number two. Favor is going to make you move you from obscurity to a fame that even in your dream, you never had it. No. You were a local champion before you become an international champion. You were a village champion before you become a national champion. People never heard the name of your family, but suddenly people are coming from far and wide to come and know your family because of you. Men who you never thought will dare come to say, I want to marry you. They will be lining up and begging you to say yes. Your husband wants to give you a first present for marriage. It's a yacht. That has at least 5 rooms with air condition, with a swimming pool inside the yacht. Somebody say, oh, is this man? He used to work in a company, and now you are the CEO. Eh? Your mates will come and say, how come? You will see. As they move, they die. Because the only thing they will see is you prospering. Yeah. I'm talking of somebody that God is about to advertise. Yeah. Listen. Solomon was not the first person in his bloodline. Solomon was not the firstborn. Solomon was even not even the thirdborn. David had children, many, when he was in exile. He had two wives. He had children for him. His first son is Amnon. But Amnon never became king because something was missing. There was no favor there. But when Solomon was born, God said, I loved him. His name should be Jedida. That was his name. Before he turned to Solomon, Jedida is what was his name. Beloved of the Lord. We'll be right back.